Welcome back to the show. Well, you probably heard of the Invictus Games, and Prince Harry and all that. He started the foundation nearly a decade ago, inspired by the power of sport and how it can help those battling mental or physical challenges.
The goal is to help reintegrate veterans back into normal life using sports to inspire that recovery. Let's bring in Jai Martin, a veteran in Newcastle, and James Brown from the Invictus Games Australia here in the studio. Thank you both so much for your time. Jai, I want to come to you first. Today is such an incredible day for the country to come together and remember your service. Thank you for your service. How do you reflect on a day like this?
Hi, Sarah. Thanks for that. Today's a very special day, and for me, it's all about bringing the family together and to remember those that have served. We attend the local dawn service down here at Madawi, and come down, remember those that have served not only at Gallipoli and on the beaches at Gallipoli, but for those that have served across all conflicts in the past.
Yeah, and we remember those too, who obviously passed away giving their lives to this country, but many came back with lifelong injuries, right? And you were amongst those who suffered a great deal, and that road back, not easy.
Yeah, you're right there, Carl. I suffered a life-changing back injury while deployed back in 2017. And yeah, it's been a bit of a recovery for me, but one thing, sport has definitely played a massive part in that. And a huge thank you to Invictus Australia for providing me that pathway. And now I'm lucky enough to work for them and help the veteran community on their road back to recovery.
James, I want to bring you in there. You served overseas. Today is an incredibly important day, and wrapping Invictus around it as well is so important for those veterans who came back with these injuries, right?
We've been enormously lucky with Invictus. So we'll take 31 athletes, their families, their dogs, their wheelchairs, their kids over to Europe this year to compete against veterans from all across the world. Mm. And then we've got people like Jai who are doing that at a grassroots level in places like the Hunter, where we know there are heaps of veterans living who connect with us. We connect them into sport. We connect them with major sporting codes. We do a lot of work with the NRL and other sporting codes. And it's all about getting them active in a community, putting a community around them, bringing a positive force to their lives, and it's life-changing.
A lot of this stuff is psychological, and I can't imagine or comprehend the things that you saw. What difference does this make?
This makes a huge difference. You know, I've been lucky enough to be involved with Invictus Australia as chairman now, but before that as one of the directors for the Sydney Invictus Games. That was such a powerful moment to help Australians see what veterans can do, to help them understand what they've been through. Mm. To give them some sense of ownership for the veterans who've served and particularly those that have come back and are having a tough time. And it's amazing that, you know, we've been able to get so many people over to the games and so many people competing, whether it's just family days where they're playing archery or whether it's more serious elite level sport.
I guess days like this are obviously so important because it would be almost impossible to return from service having not felt the impact of what you're doing over there.
Completely. I mean, look, the tie I'm wearing today belonged to a guy called Andrew Christie, one of my friends who I deployed to Iraq with in 2005, who sadly took his own life 6 years ago, leaving behind a two-year-old daughter. And we know from the Royal Commission into Veteran and Defence Suicide that there are a lot of people who've had really tough times. But we know that we're doing a lot more for them. We're putting a lot more around them. The government's stepping up. And because of the census question, we now know where veterans live and what we can do for them.
Good on you. It's so important. Jai, just finally with you, you've got your family around. Four of your beautiful kids, or three and a half, are there with you today. Do you get that they have a sense of what you went through? And I'm sure they're grateful to have Dad back and mobile, partly as a result of what you're doing for Invictus as well.
Yeah, you're right there, Carl. While I was deployed, two of the kids here, they went through that deployment with me. They were back on the home front, so they missed Dad for 6+ months. But yeah, back at home now, Anzac Day is a special day to pay tribute and for them to remember and for them to show their respect to people in uniform now, because they've seen what it's like to be a defence family. Yeah. It's important for them.
Good on you. Thank you so much for being with us, James and Jai. And again, thank you for your service.
Thanks
appreciate
so much.
Thank you. Thanks,
you.
Thanks.